Hi, I'm Rosianna, and this is my 2017 Project for Awesome video.
I spent several days in Rio Sucio listening to people of all generations talk about a conflict that has forced constant pain and terrible losses on their families, communities, and region. On our way back to Bogota, we stopped again at the UNHCR offices in Apartado to meet a women's group supported by the UN Refugee Agency. The women in this group had experienced sexual and domestic violence, and one member described the role of the UN Refugee Agency here as brazos que nos pueden ayudar, arms that can help us. I didn't film the support group while everyone was talking, but when I asked about the impact the group has had, the women said, "We didn't know our rights, and now we are learning. We help other women and teach them." The group meets weekly in spaces provided by the UN Refugee Agency, as well as other local offices. They have guest speakers and run workshops and training and learn about their rights under the law. And the women and girls are trying to pass multiple levels of trauma. I heard some devastating stories. One woman said, "My sister's husband was taken. They said he was collaborating. She came out to find him tortured and dead. And then you had to ask the people who did it permission to remove the body from the land." Another, "They killed my husband and my uncle, and so I was displaced." The thing about displacement, you don't know where to go or what to do because you don't know who's safe to talk to. The armed group's always saying that if you talk to someone, you're their collaborator. This women's group, though, is un espacio donde compartimos, a space we share things. The realities and horrors of the conflict often go unspoken and unaddressed. But here is a space where their experiences can be shared together, where they can heal together. "Ya soy capaz," said one of the women. "I am capable." "Salgo en la calle y vamos a la marcha," said another. "We march on the streets for women." "Now we know where to go," said a third, "if we are attacked or our neighbor is."
Lo único que quiero es que no siga la violencia contra la mujer, porque nosotras, como mujeres visibles de Urabá, estamos en contra de la violencia contra la mujer, de la violencia con las mujeres, ¿sí? Entonces, ¿qué quiero yo? Darle un consejo a todos los que quieren maltratar a las mujeres, que no lo sigan haciendo, que la mujer es lo más lindo que hay en el mundo, ¿sí? Y por ellas vivimos y por ellas están todos.
It's so hard to show the breadth of impact the UN Refugee Agency has had around the world because of that very thing, the scale. The scale of need, the particularities of every country in which it operates, and every different crisis to which it attends, and the local, community-focused understanding required in each situation. But in just 5 days in Colombia, as in my few days in the refugee camps in Jordan last year, I saw so many examples of UN Refugee Agency officers and local partners creating opportunities people have never been afforded, in the role of educational resources, support network, and friend, at a time when we are being told in many of our countries that those who have been forced to flee their homes are taking advantage and are unwelcome. As of September 2017, the UN Refugee Agency had a 54% funding gap, which corresponds to $4.4 billion. If you'd like to support the UN Refugee Agency and its vital work around the world, please vote for this video at projectforawesome.com before noon Eastern on the 17th of December. Consider making a donation to the UN Refugee Agency at unhcr.org/rosianna and sign the petition linked below to say that you stand with refugees.